Driving to work before dawn last winter, Valerie Norris heard an NPR report about a terrible disease spreading in China, a pandemic, people were starting to call it. It sounded sad but very far from Rocky River, Ohio, where she'd led the Rockport Early Childhood Center for 34 years. A few weeks later, she knew better. It was still dark on the chilly morning of March 13 when Norris pulled into the big parking lot at the Rockport United Methodist Church, where her school was based. She knew it was the last morning she'd walk down this hallway for a while. She didn't imagine it was the beginning of the end of her center, of her career, of the community she had worked so hard to build. "We've weathered storms before," Norris, 61, said of her center, located in a suburb about 10 miles west of Cleveland. "But this one is a tsunami. By August, the doors had closed for good. We're grieving," she said. "I know it doesn't hold a candle to the loss of life that's happening in our country, but the pandemic yielded losses of so many sorts." Norris is adamant that no one sees her as a victim. She wants to concentrate on the heart of the matter, the children, the parents and the teachers. And she wants to know, could it have been avoidable? Could some sort of safety net have been offered to sustain us, to fortify us? Many thousands of child care providers caught in the same tsunami that knocked out Rockport are asking the same questions, as are many thousands more who have stayed open, but barely. All of them are caught in the unworkable math of pandemic child care, too few tuition-paying children to support the needed staff. Too many new expenses required to keep the doors open safely. Too few loans and grants available to help bridge the gap for the mostly female small business owners who provide the bulk of the nation's child care. These effects have been especially stark in communities of color. Child care workers are disproportionately women of color, thousands of whom have continued working with minimal protection while many thousands more lost their jobs. Affordable, quality child care was already scarce in Latino and Native communities, according to research on child care deserts by the Center for American Progress, a progressive think tank. And while less likely to live in child care deserts, median-income black families already pay a larger share of their income on child care than other groups, the center found. Publicly funded programs for those living in poverty are more likely to survive the current storm, but there aren't enough of those programs to serve everyone who needs them. And closures in the private sector have left many families without safe child care options. For families of color, a disproportionate number of whom are headed by essential workers or single parents, the problem is again exacerbated.